Our communion antiphon. I'm sorry. Our entrance antiphon. Here is a wise virgin from among the number of the prudent who went forth with a lighted lamp to meet Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today we join with the church to celebrate the feast of Saint Francis Xavier Cabrini, the first American citizen who was canonized and also the patroness of the other immigrants and migrants. And the special intention for this mass is for the for Jan O'Brien. With that in mind, let us acknowledge our sin and so prepare ourselves for the sacred mysteries.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, our Father, who caused Saint Francis Xavier Cabrini from Italy to serve the immigrants of America, by her example, teach us to have concern for the stranger, the sick, and all those in need. And by her prayers, help us to see Christ in all the men and women we meet. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. John. Chosen Lady, I rejoice greatly to find some of your children walking in the truth, just as we were commanded by the Father. But now, Lady, I ask you, not as though I were writing a new commandment, but the one we have had from the beginning. Let us love one another. For this is love, that we walk according to his commandments. This is the commandment, as you heard from the beginning, in which you should walk. Many deceivers have gone out into the world, those who do not acknowledge Jesus Christ as coming in the flesh, such as the deceitful one and the Antichrist. Look to yourselves that you do not lose what we work for, but may receive a full recompense. Anyone who is so progressive as not to remain in the teaching of the Christ does not have God. Whoever remains in the teaching has the Father and the Son. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Blessed are they whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Blessed are they who observe his decrees, who seek him with all their heart. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. With all my heart I seek you. Let me not stray from your commands. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Within my heart, I treasure your promise that I may not sin against you. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Be good to your servant that I may live and keep your words. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord. Open my eyes that I may consider the wonders of your law. Blessed are they who follow the laws of the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Stand erect and raise your heads because your redemption is at hand. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be in the days of the Son of Man. They were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, up to the day that Noah entered the ark and the flood came and destroyed them all. Similarly, as it was in the days of Lot, they were eating, drinking, and buying, selling, planting, building on the day when Lot left Sodom. Fire and brimstone rained from the sky to destroy them all. So it will be on the day the Son of Man is revealed. On that day, someone who is on the housetop and whose belongings are in the house must not go down to get them, and likewise one in the field must not return to what was left behind. Remember the wife of Lot. Whoever seeks to preserve his life will lose it, but whoever loses it will save it. I tell you, on that night, there will be two people in one bed. One will be taken, the other left. And there will be two women grinding meal together. One will be taken, the other left." They said to him in reply, "Where, Lord?" He said to them, "Where the body is, there also the vultures will gather." The Gospel of the Lord.
When I was a little boy, in our hometowns, we had to go to Mass very early, and mostly we go to the daily Mass. We woke up from very early in the morning and be ready with a very nice dress. We learned that we cannot eat anything before Mass for an hour, and we need to be sincere anytime we go to Mass. When I was a little boy, I learned that we're supposed to remember all the basic prayers, and then we, from before we enter to the faith formation for children, we already learn how to do the rosary by ourselves. I learned that anytime when we go to Mass, we have to come a little bit early, so that we can prepare our soul and our spirits and ask God to be with us so that we're not going to be distracted by anything else around. And then we're supposed to stay back with several extra prayer at the end of the Mass before we left. I also learned that any time when we just see the image of of God and all the crucifix and other saints, we always make a sincere gesture. And there are much more things that we learned about how to practice and honor our God, to practice our faith and honor our God. And then when we come in here to United States, and when the society changing, the door is open so that everybody is make easy. A lot of people around us just make everything is easy as well. It's so easy for people to skip their daily prayer. It's just like with a simple excuse that sometimes I don't want to do it. Sometimes I feel lazy, or sometimes because I'm so busy. Some people may skip the Mass, come to Mass very late, and leave the Mass very early. Do whatever they want, even in the Mass, checking phone, talking with other people, and still come to receive the communion as just something that they usually do without any intention and any sincerity. Some people forgot about, don't even know any prayer, the basic prayer. They don't have anything in their mind, and they don't know what to do when they go to confession, and so on and so forth. So in the gospel today, Jesus just mentioned that sometimes we just take a look at other people and the society around you that they just lack of their religious practice. And then we just think like, oh, you know, sometimes we're better than them and we also lack of the religious practice ourselves. Sometimes we take a very easy the way how we come to Mass, the way how we worship God and honor God. But then at the end, as we just see that two people in the house, one may remain and one may be taken. So have we ever asked ourselves, who are we? Who are we? We will continue to remain with God? Will we continue to remain in the journey of faith, or we will be taken away because we just flow with other people when we forget what we need to do and try to make easy in the way of religious practice? Be careful any time when we just talking about God, any time when we come up to his house, any time when we receive these sacraments, because it is said, where the body is, there also the virtues will gather. Please stand. Mindful of our dependence on God, let us humbly place our knees before him.
For the church, as it works to build the kingdom of God here and now, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected officials, may the Holy Spirit guide them in prudence and charity in their decision-making. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer the pain of loss, may Christ's compassion be with them in their grief. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here today, may God's presence help us in our striving to be better disciples. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the living intentions of Jen O'Brien, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed, may God's infinite love welcome them into eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us offer our own intentions in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of mercy, we come before you seeking your will. We ask that you hear the prayers we offer today through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Through the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who came to share in our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we will receive the bread we offer you. Fruits of the earth and work of human hands, we become for us the breath of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruits of the vine and work of human hands, we become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon this sacrificial gift offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with love and devotion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Like a thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, his death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with reverent hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and given thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate a memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, a partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Calvin, Timothy, Titan, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed Apostle, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit, let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Dear Jesus, come into my heart and be with me today.
Our communion antiphon. Behold, the bridegroom is coming. Come out to meet Christ the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of inquiry may endure in those your heavenly powers has entered. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowls about the world seeking of the ruins of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us go in joy and peace, glorifying God with our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer is strength and protection for priests and religious. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.